Hi, Sophie here. Welcome back to my channel. So I love making pieces in Blender that are inspired by field guides and nature journal pages, which means combining paintings, drawings, and writing. And for the sake of I can't be bothered to use multiple programs, it was very important for me to find a way to do all of this within Blender for my pieces to just be one single render. And so today I'll be sharing how I add text to my art and also how I give that text a transparent outline so that I can just plop it on top of any part of my painting without having to worry about the painting strokes impeding on the readability of the text. Part one, adding a paper texture. That is already not what this video is about. I know. But the way in which I add text is both affected by the paper texture that I use and also affects the paper texture. I also just really love adding paper textures to my piece. I always paint on top of paper textures, and I also like being able to start from different values depending on what the piece needs, so I can choose between light, medium, and dark valued paper textures. So I'll link below where I learned how to add paper textures in this way. And it is so easy. You just go into the World Properties tab. You change the color by pressing on this dot. And what you want to do is select an image texture. And then here, you can add an image. And then these are the settings, but the only one that you should have to change from the default is to change the vector to window. So this also means that whatever size paper texture you use, it will stretch accordingly to fit whatever dimensions your canvas are. So a very long time ago, I made a video about painting in a watercolor style with grease pencil, and I mentioned that the render image didn't look color-wise exactly the same as it did in my 3D viewport. And I truly believe that this must have been due to how I added the paper texture, because with this new method, that is no longer a problem. The colors look exactly the same, and I am so grateful for that. That helps so much. And so now part two, adding text. So I'll go into object mode and press Shift A to add a text object. And then I like to go to the item transforms and give it a rotation value of 90 along the X axis. And so I'll also need to place the text in front of my grease pencil object. We want it to be between the camera and the grease pencil object. And so we can do this just by pressing G to move it and Y to move it closer to the camera along the Y axis. And so you can see the movement if you look at your scene from the side. I like to use an orthographic type camera rather than a perspective camera, just because of how I use Blender essentially as a 2D painting software. This is just easier for me. This also means that moving the text along the y-axis does not at all alter its scale or location as it would do if I used a perspective camera. So this is just a little thing that works a lot easier for me. So I'll select my text again, and then in materials, I'll create a new material and then just give it a random dark color. And then I also like to change the font in the object data properties of the text. So if I want to use multiple different fonts, I'll usually duplicate a text object and assign a new font to that one. It's very rare that within the same text object, I'll want to use multiple fonts. But if that is the case, then I can also use the bold and italic versions to give them completely different fonts if I want to. There's no rules. And then when I'm typing in edit mode, I can just turn those options on and off to change which font that I'm using. So some other text settings that I like to play around with. In geometry, we have the bevel depth to thicken them. In transform, we also have the shear if we want to make speedier text. I really wrote speedier text in my script. Really, I mainly use it when I want to get an italic font from, say, a handwritten font that didn't necessarily come with an italic option. And then in spacing, I'll also modify the character spacing, the word spacing, and the line spacing. Next, how to add a transparent outline to the text. So I mentioned before that the outline is to make sure that the text is readable on top of grease pencil strokes. And so what's really cool about this is that by transparent, what I really mean is that the paper texture shows up. So in essence, it really erases the grease pencil strokes that would appear around those letters and we just get beautiful paper texture. It's so cool. So I do this by duplicating one of my text objects and then right click to snap it back into place. And then in bevel, I give it a depth of usually about 0.3. This really depends on the thickness of the font and also the size of the font, the scale of the text object. So then in materials, I press on this numbered icon next to the material name to make it a new material. And here, I turn it into a holdout material. And then I can just use G and Y once again to move it back in space so that it is behind the first text object, but still in front of our grease pencil object. So then if I render, it creates an actual empty space around the text. So that has to do with how I added the paper texture in the World Properties tab. And so the quickest way to remedy this issue is to use my previous method for adding a paper texture, which is to do so in the compositing workspace. So this may seem like an extra step, but really it doesn't bother me too much, because these are actually all nodes that I have set up in my default starter 2D animation file. And so I don't need to go adding them every time that I make a new piece. Just a reminder that you can modify the default starter file by opening up a new file, making whatever changes you want to it, and then go into File, Defaults, Save Startup File. So really, this node setup is a set it and forget it kind of a thing. And even to set it up, all you need to do is to add an image node. You can open up the dropdown of the images that you've used in your file and just find it here. And then add a scale node, plug those two together, and then select the option for render size and select, well, it's already stretched, so that's perfect. And then you want to add an alpha over node and connect these nodes into the top of the alpha over node, and then the renders layer node you want to connect to the bottom. So the only thing to note, and doing this video did make me realize this, but so the holdout areas will seamlessly transition into the rest of the paper texture when you render your image at 100%, and so just keep that in mind. So thank you so much for being here. If this was helpful, please consider liking the video and subscribe for more grease pencil excitement. For more ways to support me, please check out my Gumroad and my Patreon. I also do pet commissions, and you can find me all over the internet at Sophie Jantak. I will see you very soon. I hope you're doing well. Take care. Bye.